Let's get started with today's class, Corollaries to Base Angle Theorems and its Converse. We saw what were base angle theorems in the previous class. So whenever the base angle theorem states that whenever we have an isosceles triangle okay, previous class we saw that there were two base angle theorems and its converse. So whenever we had two of the sides equal, then in a triangle, then the angles opposite to those sides will also be congruent by base angle theorem. And by its converse, we had whenever we have two base angles equal, the sides opposite to those base angles will be congruent by converse theorem. Okay, these sides will be congruent. We saw that in base angle theorem and its converse. Now we are saying corollaries. If a triangle is equilateral, then it's equiangular, which we already know. And if a triangle is equiangular, then it's equilateral. These two things are the corollaries of a base angle theorem and its converse. And we already know that, but just we will be using that more often now on for our proofs or problem solving. Let's see the next slide. They are asking us to prove that D is a midpoint of EF and D is midpoint of UG. Then prove that EF is parallel to UF. Okay, they want us to prove that EG is parallel to UF. EG is parallel to UF. We got to prove this. So I'll just write the statements, and meanwhile, if you can help me with the reasons, we can finish this earlier. Okay. Use your chat to complete the reasons for each of those steps. As and when I write statements. So first, I have D is midpoint of EF. And second, I have D is midpoint of UG. These two, I'm writing the reasons as they were simple, given. Then third, I will write angle EDG equals angle EDG is congruent to UDF. You got to fill the reason for this in your chat. And then I'll write ED equals DF. Fill this as well. Then I'll also write DG equals UD. UD equals DG. Okay. Then I can say that triangle EGD is congruent to triangle DUF. I said these two triangles are congruent, and next I'm saying this. Next I'm saying, next step I'm saying these two angles are congruent. I'll just say these two angles are congruent. Next I'll be saying these two angles are congruent, and you have to tell the reasons why these are congruent once I've proved the triangles are congruent. I'm going to say these two angles are congruent in the next step, and after that next step will be this final step. So seventh step, angle EGD is congruent to angle DUF. So fill up the reason for this as well. It's third, fourth, fifth, sixth, and seventh. And finally, last step is your EG equals UF. EG is parallel to UF. Tell the reason for this as well. I'll give you some time to list out this reason, and we will discuss the answer soon. Okay. Use your chat and list out, label the numbers and list out all the reasons. Let's see if you can get them. You all pointed out reasons till 6, they are absolutely right. So this was EDG and UDF. They formed EDG, angle EDG, and angle UDF. They formed the vertical angle pair, so vertical angle pair postulate. Or vertical congruency theorem. Vertical angle pair postulate, I'll just write that. And on this one, ED equals DF, this was definition of midpoint, let's say maybe ED equals DG. And this one also was definition of midpoint. And then we showed triangles are congruent by SAS congruency postulate. Because if you observe here, I have a side, then I had these two angles congruent, so angle at this side. So if you observe a triangle, it is just SA, yes. Then you will have EGD is congruent to DUF. So I just want to check your answers for 7th and 8th. I will check, so let's see what you have for 7th and 8th. After this, I'm saying angle EGD is congruent to DUF. Then I'm saying EG is parallel to UF. Okay, if you have the answers for 7th and 8th, list them. One, that triangles are congruent, we can alternate. We can already say that if the two triangles are congruent, then their corresponding parts are also congruent by CPCTC. You studied in the previous class. CPCTC stands for corresponding parts of congruent triangles are congruent. I'm just writing it short form. Corresponding parts of congruent triangles are congruent. Okay. That's your CPCTC. Here you all said alternate interior angles. These will form alternate interior angles. That I know. We can use alternate interior angle theorem when we know they are parallel. If we have proved that alternate interior angles are congruent, and then we say they are parallel, it becomes converse of alternate interior angle theorem. I hope this is clear. So alternate interior angle theorem. Okay, let's see the next slide. Same way, let's do this as well. Given that AS bisects RT and AS is perpendicular to RT, true triangle RST is isosceles. Okay. To prove triangles are isosceles, we need to prove that two sides will be congruent. Okay. We have to prove that two sides are congruent in the triangle. Okay, let's first get started. Statement. And then reasons. You all can list the reasons as we did for the previous one. AS bisects RT, comma, AS is perpendicular to RT. Okay, this was given, so I'm just writing given. For the second step, if AS bisects RT, I'm writing RA is congruent to AT. List out the reason for this. RA is congruent to, or A, RA equals AT, I can say that also. Okay. List out the reason for that. Then next, I will say AS is perpendicular to RT, so I will say this is 90 degrees, this is also 90 degrees. Okay, then finally I will say AS is congruent to AS. Okay. The next step I'll say triangle TAS and RAS are congruent. Triangle RAS is congruent to triangle TAS. You all list out the reason for that. Then I can say RS equals ST. Or I can just say RS is congruent to ST. That will make us to conclude that triangle RST is isosceles. Triangle. Okay. List out the reason for these seven steps. I'll give you some time, but then we'll discuss. As you all listed out, absolutely right. Second one, RA is congruent to AT by definition of bisector. And then next, I had these two 90 degrees by definition of perpendicular. Right. Whenever we have perpendicular, there we will have a 90 degree. Keep that in mind. And AS is congruent to AS, which is a reflexive property. And this is nothing but SAS. say S congruency postulate. Then RS is congruent to ST, RS is congruent to ST is your CPCTC as you all had indicated, which is nothing but congruent parts of corresponding parts of congruent triangles are congruent. Corresponding parts of congruent triangle are congruent. And this is seventh one. I think it's just definition of isosceles triangle. Okay. Whenever you have two sides which are equal, that in a triangle, you can say it's an isosceles triangle. Definition of isosceles triangle. Okay, let's see the next one. I think that's the last proof. It's not the proof, you're solving for the values. I'm not going to help you with this, you are solving independently. Call this as 1. In case of 1, tell me what is the value of x and y. In case of 2, tell me what is the value of x, y and z. I'm going to give you like a minute. Okay. Work this out, take a minute or so, complete that and let me know once you have completed. I would use the chat to tell your answers once you have completed. Okay, let's take a look at answers. So here, I had 121 degrees. I know the sum of angles in a straight line will be 180. So I can find this angle. This angle is nothing but 180 minus 121. 180 minus 121 will give me 59 degrees. If this is 59 degrees, I know this line is parallel to this particular line. So therefore, this angle is also equal to 59 degrees. Okay, in the previous class, you studied that in a triangle, if two sides are equal, then their opposite angles are equal. Their opposite angles are equal. I know these two sides are equal. So these two angles are supposed to be equal. This is 59 degrees, so therefore, this is also 59 degrees. To get x, I can say x plus 59 plus 59 equals 180. And once I solve for x, I'll get x equals 62. So that's how I have 62 degrees. Okay, now let's think about how to get y. Okay, if this is 59 degrees, this is 59 degrees. I can say that this whole angle is 59 degrees because these are corresponding. This is 59, so this is 59, and this will end up being 59 because of corresponding angles. Okay, apply corresponding angle continuously and get these angles. This is 59. Apply corresponding angle once, you'll get 59 here. Apply once more on these two lines because these two lines are also parallel. So this is also 59. And we know 59 plus x plus y equals 180 because they form a straight line. So I can say 59 plus x plus y equals 180 degrees. So further substitute here 59, and you had the value of x which is 62. Plus y equals 180. Solving for y, you'll get y equals 180 minus 59 minus 62, which is 59 degrees. Okay. That should have been the answer for the first one. Now let's see the second one. Let's use different color for second one. Okay, if this is 51 and these two sides are equal, then the opposite angles to these sides are equal. This angle and this angle will be equal. These two angles will be equal by our base angle theorem. I know this is 51. Adding the sum of angles in a triangle is 180, so I can say 51 plus x equals 180. So you'll have 51 plus 2x equals 180. Further simplify and you will get the value of x as 64.5. Okay. 180 minus 51 divided by 2, you can do that. I'm just not writing some more steps. You will have 64.5 degrees. So that's your value of x. Okay. Now observe here. I have a 90 degrees here, this whole angle. This whole angle is 90 degrees. But I need only this particular angle, which I'm putting a dot over here. I need only this angle. So this angle is going to be 90 degrees minus, I already found this angle equal to x, which is 64.5. Okay. This was equal to x and the x equals 64.5. So 90 minus 64.5 will give me this angle, which is nothing but 25.5. 25.5. degrees. Okay, now observe this particular triangle. They have given these two sides are equal, then their opposite angles will be equal. So this angle y will be equal to this particular angle which you found. You know this angle is 25.5, so the angle y will also be equal to 25.5 degrees. Okay, and you can find z by taking sum of 2y's. This is 25.5, this is 25.5 plus z equals 180. So you can say y plus z equals 180. So you write 25.5 plus 25.5 plus z equals 180. And use your calculator further. This will be 51. 180 minus 51 will give the value of z, which is 129. Okay, 129 degrees. That's your final answer. I think that's it for today's class. There is a review packet which is there on the hub. You can start working on it. Go over the review. It's not going to be due till 3 days after your Thanksgiving. I'm not going to make it due till 3 days after your Thanksgiving, but utilize this time to work on that particular review. Okay. Hope you all have a wonderful Thanksgiving, but stay on call, work on review. In case you have any questions, please ask me now. Okay.